Merry Christmas! So what is Christmas in July? Well, it's a tradition that began back in the 1930s at a girls' camp in North Carolina, and it's become a cultural staple each year. So in honor of this tradition, I thought it would be fun to make a vintage granny square stocking. For this project, you'll need 14 granny squares, and you can use whatever style granny square you like. I'm just using a traditional granny with four rounds that measures about 4 by 4 inches. I made mine reversible, meaning it looks the same on both sides, using a weight 4 cotton yarn with a 4 millimeter hook. The stocking consists of 4 panels. To create your panels, work from top to bottom. For panel 1, you'll need 3 squares. Fold your first square in half lengthwise, then place 2 full squares on top of each other. Panel 2, start with 2 full squares this time, followed by 1 square folded in half lengthwise. For panel 3, you'll need 4 squares. Fold your first square in half lengthwise, followed by 2 full squares on top of each other, then fold 1 square on the diagonal to form the top of the toe. For panel 4, you'll need 4 squares again. Fold the first square on the diagonal to form the heel, then 2 full squares on top of each other, and then finally a square folded in half lengthwise. Next, it's time to join each panel using your favorite joining technique. This can be with your crochet hook or with a tapestry needle. I decided to do a flat seam join where I use the back bump of the stitches to make the seam. This is a flat seam join that gives a really nice texture to your seam. I do have a video tutorial that goes into more depth with this, but I will be teaching it here in the video as well. If you decide you want to use this method, I recommend that you place all of your squares on the wrong side or as if you're working inside out. If you made reversible squares like I have, then just double check that all of your squares are facing outwards, making sure that you have the bumpy side facing you. To do the seaming, I take 3 lengths of the square that I'm working on. That should be plenty for your seaming. I like to put a little knot just to help me from pulling the end through. You can undo that later if you want. Working into the corner, here's the back bump for that corner. Back bump for this corner. And now I'm just going to make sure that I'm lining up the clusters, and then I'm just going to continue working into the back bumps. When I say back bump, it's just the back of the stitch, and sometimes it's not exactly perfect. Just make sure that you're lining everything up and you're just not going into the front of the stitches. And then what will happen is the stitches on the front will line up beautifully. I just really love the textured look of this. Final back bumps. And that's the effect that you'll get, a sort of raised flat seam join. And then with your third one, you're going to join again. And now one more join to complete our first panel join. And then to weave these ends in, I get a lot of questions about this. I just go in and tidy up the side a little bit. And then I'm just going to weave into a cluster. I find that to be the best way to hide the tails. And that's your first panel completed, and you can fold it back into the position. You have your half panel here on the side with your full panel on the right. I'm going to go ahead and put mine inside out again because I'll be joining this with the back bump later. So half panel lengthwise with the two full panels on the right, the side, and pull in the next two to join. For the second panel, just repeat what you did for panel one. We have the full sides on the left and the half panel on the right. Okay, panel three. Just take your time with this. Try to stay on track with what you've joined. The easiest way to go about this, I found, is just join these three panels together, making sure that you leave an opening. Just have two sides available to bring in your diagonal square. So I'm going to go ahead and do that first, and then we'll come back and do this piece together. Okay, the first three squares are joined, so we're just going to fold that into place. That's the right side. I'm working on the back side. So we're going to take this half and join to this half, flip over, and join this half to this half. Okay, let's go for it. Just making sure everything's lining up. This cluster on the corner here is going to match up with this cluster. Corners match up nicely here. Flip it over. Line everything up. Bring in another corner. Doesn't have to be perfect, just make sure it's reinforced and it looks good and feels nice and secure for you. That is all that matters, and do the best that you can for lining things back up. Looks like I'm off a little bit, but we can fix that. We can fudge it a little bit. Not a big deal. Before I fasten off, I just want to have a look at that, make sure I'm happy with it. And I am. So I'm going to go ahead and weave in this end and get ready for panel four. Now we're ready for panel four. So panel four should look something like this. And we're going to do the exact same thing that we did for panel three. We're going to join these first three squares together, and then we'll come back to do the diagonal. And here are our three squares joined together, and it's ready. We have two sides available to join to the diagonal square here. So we're just going to do like we did before. Have the wrong sides facing outward. Okay, all matching. Let's just get everything back in alignment here. Alignment is good. So now we're just going to take our heel and join it. So we're just going to join across here, flip it over, and join from here to here, and we're good to go. And that's your fourth panel completed. Come on, baby. I've got to do the rest of the video. Really? And you should have something that looks like this, and we are ready to go ahead and join all four panels together. Don't worry about this portion here. Once we do the shaping, this is going to be a really pretty foot. Everything should be pretty self-explanatory. Just line everything up the way you want it, and then I'll meet you back here where we get to this little corner edge. The main tip I have here as you're joining this is just to line everything up before you get started, just making sure the clusters are lining up. You're going to have awkward areas where there's not a back bump, particularly that you're joining into if you're doing my method. Your main goal here is you just don't want to have a really big gap where there should be a nice tight join. So you're just going to play around with that a little bit. And here in this little corner here, you'll see you have this kind of space here, and you're going to have one cluster that you're going to be joining all of this to, sort of into that little dip there. So I'm coming to that little intersection here, and again, I've got my little cluster that's going to go right in between these two corner clusters, and I'm just going to do my best to make sure that everything is nice and snugly together. I'm not going to stress out too much on this, lining up with the back bumps properly or anything like that. I just want to make sure that it's a nice, secure join. Just finding a spot that looks good to me. And after I've done this, I can always turn it around and double check. So I've got that center lined up with that cluster. And I'm just going to sneak and take that and bring it in there. And that should be good. I'm going to reinforce that a little bit. Make it a little bit more tight, and then continue on. And again, for panel four, you're just going to do the same thing. You're just going to line everything up the best that you can, just to give a nice secure join. If it's not perfect, it doesn't matter. As long as it lines up close enough, you'll be good to go. And then when you're finished with that, we'll work on this portion together. This is where we're going to join and shape the toe. To work the bottom portion, really easy to do. We're just going to do a whip stitch across the bottom, and we're going to cut into the granny square here towards the middle to give that rounded corner or rounded edge. I'm just taking the yarn and just whipping it around all the stitches. Okay, so now I'm just going to work my way up to the center of that square. So I'm just going to weave my way up and down. Trying to get into the meat of the stitches to help anchor things in place. And what I would recommend you do, if this is your first time doing this, I would test it before committing to weaving in your ends. Just make sure you like the look of it. You may want to go a little bit higher, or you may want to go all the way across and just kind of tuck it in if you don't like doing this. If you like, you can go back down the way you came just to make it even stronger. You hear the cats in the background. Have a look at that. Yep, that works for me. Go ahead and grab a complementary color, whichever one you like for the top. I'm just going to pull out the red here. I'm going to fasten on with a standing single crochet. Add a slip knot to your hook, working into any space you like. Pull your yarn through, yarn over, pull through. And that's a standing single crochet. So we already have a single crochet done. I'm going to do a chain three to get over to the next space. One, two, three. Single crochet into the space. Now when you come to an area like this, let's do this. One, two, three. Single crochet. And then for an area like this, I just like to do a chain two. I found a chain two works a lot better for this because it's a little bit too loose with a chain three. And then single crochet, and then continue on. Chain three, single crochet into the space, chain three, single crochet into the space. I'm back to the very first single crochet. I'm just going to go in and fasten off with a slip stitch into the top of that first single. Chain one more to fasten off. Typically with a block stitch, you'll do three double crochets into the chain three spaces, but I want to do it a little bit shorter, so I'm just going to do half double crochets for this. But you may prefer to go up to a full double crochet. It doesn't matter. It's not going to affect the pattern in any way if you decide to do that. And I'm just going to do three half double crochets into each chain three space, and also three half double crochets in those chain two spaces. So I'm just fastening on with a slip stitch. I'm going to chain two to serve as my first half double, and then two half doubles into the same space. And that's all there is to it. We're just going to continue this all the way around. Three half doubles into each chain space. And then to fasten off, add a slip stitch into the beginning of that very first stitch you made. Chain one, and then tighten. And to finish things off, I'm going to do single crochets into the top of all of those half doubles. And at this point, you can also decide where you want to have your little hanger, because that's where you can fasten on, because when you fasten off, you can continue on to make your hanger. And so I'm going to go into the center here. I'm just going to do a standing single crochet, so add a slip knot to the hook, pull the yarn through, single crochet, and I'm just going to do singles all the way around in the top of all of those half doubles. Great, and then when you come to the end, just add a slip stitch into the beginning of that first single. And now you can create your hanger. And I'd recommend about 15 to 20 chains. Okay, that's good. I did 20. And at this point, you can come back down and slip stitch it to create your hanger. Or if you want to reinforce it a little bit, you can add single crochets to your chain. Working into the second chain from the hook, 1, 2, add a single crochet, and just continue all the way down. And I'm just going to slip stitch into the base of that stitch. Give myself a tail to work with. And using that tail, I'm just going to tack that in place. Make it nice and strong, because I'm going to believe that I'm going to get a lot of presents from Santa. So I need this to really stay in place. Awesome. Okay, and I'm just going to tie those two ends together and weave those in off camera. We're going to call this good and done for now. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, a like is always appreciated. I hope you enjoyed this little taste of Christmas in July. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.